Coach Goodale, a lot of wrestling today at 2014 Flow Nationals. First off, what are the Scarlet Knights looking for?
The best guys, guys that wrestle the hardest, can wrestle all three positions. Bright kids, want to wrestle at the next level, so those are the guys we're looking for.
You guys got a ton of wrestling. They're, first off, 12 mats. Is that a little overwhelming for you at times?
You know what? Those scoreboards all over and all these rooms and stuff like that, it's pretty easy to follow. I mean, there's a lot of stuff going on. As it gets down, you know, the quarters, we'll wrestle up to the quarters tonight. It'll get interesting. Certainly tomorrow morning will be great, so we look forward to that.
All right. Last time we talked, you were a little emotional.
I was
about 35 seconds, literally 45 seconds, you guys off the mat. Parati, you know, All-American for you guys. And I don't know if you saw the piece on Flow Center. Years since Rutgers had an All-American. Zero. Did you see that?
I did see that.
Pretty
that
awesome.
Good. That was cool.
But when you look at that, you know, and it was an eighth place. A lot of people say, eighth place, whatever. But what has that done for you and your confidence in your program in the last, you know, month?
It's been, it's really been neat the last couple of weeks. You know, people are excited. I don't care. I mean, obviously, you want to keep winning and get as high on the podium as possible. But at that point, you know, leaving that tournament, having an All-American, where really we didn't know if it was going to be possible, it was going to be hard to do this year, and it came out of nowhere. It was a great run. It's been exciting. Not just through our program, but through our wrestling community, state of New Jersey, things like that. So it certainly helps with recruiting. It was a great tournament. It's a lot different coming back here this year than it was last year, if you know what I mean. So it's a good thing.
Looking at, you know, you have a guy who actually wrestled 2 years of Big Ten schedules that's going to be on your team, prospectively, if Andrew Campitano does what he needs to do in the classroom. But a guy like that, can he lead your guys through that Big Ten schedule?
Absolutely, absolutely. Knows what it takes, talks to our guys about it all the time. He's really changed since he's been back or since he left in the first place. He's come on. He's working hard. He's doing it, you know, without the whole hoopla type thing. He's been a really good example. And he's kind of talked to a lot of these guys on what it's going to take. And, you know, with the excitement of Parati and, you know, now Billy Smith really getting closer and closer every single year. We got some guys that could really win. We're obviously excited about Ashnall getting in a lineup. We got some young guys, you know, like Del Vecchio and Tyler Hunt that are going to be in that lineup that are going to do some pretty good things. So Andrew's been great for us. And, again, he's leading by example. He's preparing for University Nationals, which he looks forward to wrestling in. I'm looking forward to watching him compete. But it's pretty neat to watch him train in our room right now. And he's gotten a lot better shape over the last month. So he's going to help us for sure.
You know, obviously the name of the game is recruiting. We're here at the Flow Nationals, what your guys are here doing. But I look at a guy like Anthony Ashnall, number one recruit in the country, you know, won matches, you know, beat Joey Dance in the Super 32 finals. A guy like that, how much of an impact are you looking for him as a Scarlet Knight next year in the Big Ten and for your team?
Yeah, well, I don't want to throw all that on him. He's going to be young. He's going to take some lumps. We're in an unbelievable conference, as you know now. So, you know, night in and night out, he's going to really have his A game. But one thing I can tell you is that kid can scrap. He's a gamer. He loves the show. He likes the competition. He'll stay up for junior feelers to wrestle some of the better guys to get used to it. But he's training awfully hard. He's excited about the opportunity he has next year as a freshman going into that conference with our schedule. So if anybody's going to come out of it and we feel good that he's going to have a really, really solid year.
You got two blue chippers, you know, we've mentioned both of them. Mm-hmm. But what do you got to do to get a third, a fourth, and a fifth, sixth blue chipper like those guys?
You know, you got to keep winning at that highest level, at that national tournament. You got to keep winning. I've seen what it's done in a short couple weeks and how recruiting has changed and where Rutgers is now from a name standpoint. So you have to continue to win at that tournament. And of course, the Big Ten's is a great opportunity. It's the most visible conference there is in the country. So if we could be competitive and win some matches and beat some ranked guys throughout the course of the year and then do well in the Big Ten's, that's going to just continue to bring these better guys in. You know, we talked last time we spoke was about, is it about surround yourself with New Jersey? No, not necessarily. It's got to be the right kid. It's got to be the right kid. And that goes from New Jersey to California. So that's what we're looking for. And but winning at that tournament is awfully important.
When I talked to you at the Ohio State tournament, you know, obviously the Tom Tanis, mm-hmm. you know, question came up. The last All-American was 2002 for you guys, 184 punter Tom Tanis. But Jim Anderson, you know, he said that once you guys got an All-American, it was going to roll for you guys. Do you feel the same way?
I do. I could tell it's going to happen because it's like if Parati can do it, why not me? You know, we got guys in there that are probably better wrestlers. You know, he's just a tough son of a gun, and they're around him every single day and see how he trains. And if that guy can do it, why can't I? That's kind of what's going on right now. And he's been a really good leader that way, and he knows there's a bullet on him, and he's got to become a better leader. And, you know, it's true. If Anthony Parati can do it, we got guys in that room that can certainly do it. So, you know, I'll be forever grateful for that kid breaking down a door. He was huge. What a great run. And but now we just got to have guys to match it, and I think it's going to happen.
How does he beat the hottest wrestler in the country at that point in time, Nestor Taffer? Taffer's got Derringer on his back. This guy, you know, he's got the pressure, a lot of pressure. It's last year for Boston. Yeah. He's a Jersey kid. How do you coach him up to beat a guy like the way he did?
You know, I think it was about him believing he was going to do it. I really do. He's wrestled him before two times during the course of the year. He's a workout partner. Nestor's right down the road from us. They train together all summer long, and it's the one guy Parati really thought he could beat all year long was Nestor. He liked his draw at the IWAs was when he was an 8 seed against Tafur, who was a 1. So he just truly believed it. You know, it wasn't that he bought in that weekend. He was buying in for the last month of the season and just felt he could beat anybody. And then, you know, he has a shot to beat St. John there late, so he just felt he could beat anybody in a tournament. So he felt good about the matchup, and he's a gamer, man. That guy thinks he can wrestle with anybody, and that's a pretty good thing to have.
All right, Coach, you got anything else for me?
No, I'm good, man.
A lot of great wrestling. I'll let you get back in there. Thanks for the time.
You got it, Seth. Thanks.